All right, how's it going, guys? I'm gonna probably start doing a series of videos where I'm just gonna talk to the camera, just kind of more in-depth, personal kind of stuff, and really just talk about experience, different experiences performing magic, and maybe some hints, tips, ideas, little tricks, things to improve your performance or whatever. So, you know, throughout this series, if you have a question, a comment, or just an experience you would like to share, please post in the comment below after you watch this video, and maybe I'll answer your question. I'll mention your story in another part of this video or in this video series, and I'd really like to just kind of see where everyone is in this kind of area. Today, I really want to talk about my very first like stage performance. I got into magic when I was a freshman in high school. So this is about 2006, I believe. And you know, a buddy of mine in my world geography class was into magic, and he had just moved into town from Las Vegas. And this was the very first time I had seen like magic, like David Blaine style magic, with my own eyes. Not on TV, not on a stage, but just with my own eyes, close up. Completely blew me away. And I asked him if he would teach me a couple stuff or grab a deck of cards from home. And he taught me a couple of basics and where I can go from there, you know, if I wanted to do this by myself. And I mean, that's where I am now. And my sophomore year, this girl approaches me in my geometry class. And her and I were pretty good friends, you know. We didn't really hang out outside of school, but, you know, in class, we had a couple classes together and, you know, talk to each other. I would show her magic and she would be blown away, right? But she came up to me one day and she was like, hey, you know, I'm in choir. And we're doing this, like, holiday mosaic performance thing for Christmas. And for the show, they need a magician. So I was like, hey, I know a magician. I'll go talk to him. And so she came up to me and asked me, he's like, hey, would you like to perform a little show? I was like, hell yeah, this is going to be awesome. But that up until then, I had never done like a real stage show before. I had only done close-up magic. And I had only been in magic for, you know, about a year. So I was still pretty crappy at magic, honestly. And but I was just like, sure. And you know, even though, you know, overall the show sucked, it was a nice learning experience. You know, I got to learn what to do, what not to do, and just some an overall experience, even though it was kind of embarrassing and crappy at the time. But so I started thinking of ideas. I was like, all right, you know, what can I do? And like I said, I did only close-up magic at the time. I didn't really know any stage stuff. I didn't have money to buy big, expensive boxes and props and levitations or, you know, whatever. So I just did the best I could with what I had, with no prior knowledge whatsoever of, like, stage work or anything like that. You know, years later, I joined my high school theater department, who was very, very reputable in our state and stuff, and in the country as well. And I learned a lot about stage presence and a bunch of stuff, but you know, I wasn't there yet. So at the time, I was just kind of this shy little, believe it or not, I kind of had that kind of goth and emo kind of persona. I had long hair. If anyone has actually seen my old videos, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. I had long hair, I had straightened out, and I had it over one eye kind of thing. Oh, it was embarrassing now that I think about it. But you know, in high school, you know, my freshman, sophomore year, I was some kid that looked all dark and gothic and stuff that didn't really talk to anyone, but did kind of cool magic that impressed some people because I kind of sucked, but whatever. So I had no stage presence whatsoever, and I just tried my best, and I started to look online. I was like, okay, what kind of stage stuff could I do? And I don't know, I didn't have the resources or the knowledge or whatever, so the effects I performed in all kind of sucked. I mean, I just did a simple, you know, card force and, oh, think of your card, I'll read your mind. It was at the Nine of Diamonds, oh, yeah. So, and then I saw this one trick by David Copperfield where, you know, he would have, like, you know, he did the trick to the camera. He had a bunch of pictures, and he was like, all right, you know, think of this, do this, you know. It was more of, like, a mathematical problem or whatever, but it was kind of like, I'm going to read your mind through the camera. So I thought, hey, maybe I can do that, except with people on stage. So during rehearsal of the Mosaic performance, I tried it, and it was awful. You know, I had never tried it before, and people were really confused. The choir director was confused, and frankly, I was confused. So I cut it out of my show, and I stuck with, like, the card force. And what I eventually did was I saw Chris Angel do a trick where he would take, like, a metal chain, wrap it around his neck, have two people hold on to the two ends of the chain, pull really hard, and it goes through your neck. And I was like, dude, that's kind of cool. So maybe I should do that. So I went to Lowe's, bought a chain, practiced a few times, bought the wrong kind of chain, evidently, because it would get stuck, and it was painful. But whatever. So I ended up doing that. I had to wear this, like, ridiculous, like, wizard costume kind of thing. It was very embarrassing. But I go up in there, and the guy gives me, like, this little microphone and a little tiny amp. Now, like I said before, I took theater, so I knew all about, you know, diction, projection, and just stage presence. But at the time, I didn't know any of that. So I was just like, oh, hey, look, I have a microphone. I could just talk like this, and people through the whole place could hear me. And mind you, this was coming out from a little amp. This wasn't like a, you know, theater system where there's speakers all over the place, so just talking like this, everyone can hear me. No, I had a handheld microphone and was talking out of an amp. And I didn't really think, oh, I should start projecting my voice, even though I'm on a microphone. I didn't really think of that. So after the performance, people in the back were like, dude, we had no idea what you were talking about. We couldn't hear you. And I was like, crap. But, I mean, nothing I could do about it. But so I do the card reading thing. Back then, I didn't really know any good card forces, so it was terrible. And then I did the chain through neck thing, which I messed up twice. It didn't work because, you know, the I had to wear a little stupid wizard costume, and, like, the little robe thing was kind of getting in the way. So I took it off, and some of the girls, because I knew some of the girls in choir from, like, you know, middle school, and some of the girls were like, woo, you know, when I took off my jacket, which was kind of a confidence booster. I just took the microphone. I'm like, thank you. So I tried again, and it works, you know, the third time after I take the jacket off, and I was just like, oh, my neck, you know. And walked off stage, and that was it. I mean, that was my performance, and I came up, I had a few people, like, in the front seats that could actually hear me, and they're like, oh, man, that's cool, you know, how'd you do the chain trick, I don't know, it's cool. But I had some people come up to me that were sitting in the back, just like, dude, we had no idea what was going on, we couldn't hear you, and we just didn't know what you were doing. And the choir guy, director, comes up to me, and he's just like, yeah, I was standing in the back as well, I didn't really understand what was happening. So, but after the performance, he's like, hey, on Monday, stop by my office, I want to give you something. I'm like, okay. So I go in his office after school, and he hands me like 50 bucks, I think it was. And I didn't even know I was being paid for it. You know, he just said, hey, can you perform? I was like, sure. So he's like, hey, man, you know, thank you for helping us out. You're not even in choir, but, you know, thanks for, you know, doing the show. So I was like, oh, hey, thank you. greatly accepted. So even though overall the performance was just terrible, so bad, and there's just so many things I could have changed to make it better, I learned a lot. You know, I learned that was the very first time I ever was on stage, and it was scary. I was nervous. I didn't really have a good stage presence or anything like that, but I learned a lot. And I think that in magic, that's something that we need to remember. Not only just in stage, but even if we're doing close-up magic, we need to make sure that we are speaking clearly. I know I have a really bad stutter too. A lot of times I ramble and I'm just like, what? You know, I've done it in this video. So I know that it's difficult. You get nervous, you get scared, you forget your own name, people's other name, you drop cards, and you talk really fast, hurry up. I'm guilty of it as well. We all do it. But in magic, I think it's really, really important for us to know and learn from our past experiences. That way we can better ourselves in the future and be better. You know, if I were to go on stage today, I would still kind of suck. You know, I look back and like, I should have done this, and I should have done this. You know, I shouldn't have done that. Of course, you're always going to be your worst critique. But I'm of course a lot better than I was before. So, but you know, I'm still not a stage performer. I still have a lot to learn about my stage presence and just being able to put on a good show and entertain everyone on a stage. But I am better because of it. And like I said, that, you know, the lesson of the day is just learn from past experiences. Go outside your comfort zone. Even if overall it was total crap, you know, if someone presents you with a really cool opportunity, even if you have no idea what you're talking about, what you're doing, you know, just try to take it. Go outside your comfort zone. See what's out there. Maybe you'll like it. Maybe, you know, maybe I'll end up being a really cool, really famous, successful stage performer. Who knows? You know, and I wouldn't have known that if I never went on that stage for the first time. You know, there's just so many endless possibilities of what can or can't happen. And like I said, just go outside your comfort zone, do the best you can do, and then learn from your experiences. Whenever you perform, either on stage or even close up, I think it's really important for you to talk with your audience. Say, you know, hey, you know, I really liked it when you made this card vanish or whatever. Or, hey, you know, I didn't really understand what this trick was, blah, blah, blah. I didn't really see what you did. I didn't really hear what you did or anything like that. You know, get insight of what your audience is saying about your magic. That way you can further better yourself. So I think that's extremely, extremely important. So, well, I mean, that's pretty much it. I want to tell you my little story. Like I said before, any magicians that are watching this, leave a comment below if you have a question about just magic in general, if you want me to try to answer, or if you have a story, I'll try and mention it in a future episode of one of these kind of interactive kind of experiment kind of thing I'm doing. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.